Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome WWE Hall of Famer, the Icon, Goldberg!
This is a man, you gotta admit, has vengeance on his mind.
Goldberg has waited months for this.
Steam-breathing personification of intimidation, the WWE Hall of Famer, Goldberg, is in the house.
This time it's not about championships for Goldberg. It is personal. It is about personal vengeance. And the target for Goldberg is the almighty Bobby Lashley.
It may be personal, Saxton, but don't get ahead of yourself. We saw what the Almighty did to Goldberg at SummerSlam, and if Goldberg's not careful, it may happen again.
SEC country! Lashley has the audacity to claim that what he did to my son was a misunderstanding. It wasn't. It was intentional. So tonight, I'm inviting Bobby Lashley in this ring so I can intentionally break his freaking neck.
Over an misunderstanding?
Yeah, come on, you don't buy that too, Corey.
Why would I doubt the Almighty? Bobby Lashley's never lied to me. Bobby Lashley's never lied to the WWE
Lashley
Universe.
Lashley rendered Goldberg's son unconscious, okay? That's not a mistake. That's not an accident.
You might hear the man speak for himself. Yeah, he answers Goldberg now.
Bill, for the last time, what happened to your son at SummerSlam was a misunderstanding. And you must be out of your mind to think that I'm gonna come down to this ring right now and risk ruining this custom-made suit to whoop your ass again. You see, Bill, because some of us aren't still dressing like it's 1998. Look, I know you're angry, but you need to look at it from my point of view. You've been perpetrating this myth that I somehow hurt your son on purpose. And at this point, that's a bit of character assassination. And Bill, I think you owe me an apology. And look, I know that you want a match against me, and I'm gonna give you that match. I'm gonna give you that match at Crown Jewel under one condition: that match is no holds barred. Oh. Oh, wait a minute, Bill. And you can bring your son along too.
Thank you, Bobby. No holds barred gives me a license to kill. You think I'm crazy, and I am. You want an apology? I'll give you an apology. I'll apologize to your kids after I leave your lifeless body in the middle of the ring gasping for air. Because There's one thing for sure, Bobby Lashley. You're next. And you're dead.
You gotta wonder, does Bobby Lashley realize what he just signed up for at Crown Jewel?
We have seen Goldberg compete countless times in WWE. I have never...
No. Hold on. Hold on. Bill, you know of all people that you can't kill the Almighty. And I can see that the fruit doesn't fall too far from the tree. So you can let Gage know if he decides and he has the balls enough to do what he did last time. This time, it won't be a misunderstanding. So you tell me, Bill, what would you do? What would you do if you were standing in the middle of the ring and somebody came out and jumped on your back? What would you do if somebody came to the middle?
Cedric Alexander, Shelton Benjamin, the Hurt Business.
Literally jumping on the back of Goldberg.
Oh my God.
Yeah, Goldberg having no problem fighting both men.
Does that answer your question, Bobby?
This is what you have coming your way, Bobby Lashley. You want Goldberg a crown jewel? Be careful what you ask for.
Bobby Lashley knows exactly what he is signing up for, which is why the Almighty requested no holds barred. Hell is coming to Crown Jewel for Goldberg or Lashley.
Now, people making most of opportunities. That's what happened earlier tonight with Austin Theory making his mark.